Welcome back, and thanks for tuning in to episode 30 of LabPadre's SpaceX and Starbase weekly updates. We've got a quickie for you today, so let's dig in. In the nighttime hours of Friday, a new methane pump was inspected before being laid back down. In Florida, Doug returned to port with just read the instructions in B-1067 after a successful launch of Starlink 4-24. Returning to Boca Chica and its shipping channel, tugs were seen bringing a semi-submersible rig into port. A busy week of orbital launch mount upgrades began on Saturday, with shielding being added to the booster quick disconnect. Saturday also saw the launch of Falcon 9 with Starlink 4-35 on booster 1073 from Space Launch Complex 40 in Cape Canaveral. As Saturday night rolled into Sunday morning at Starbase, a booster stand was moved into the mega bay ahead of the first components of Booster 9. The next day, Booster 7 was attached to both of the bridge cranes in mega bay to provide easy access for engine swaps and other upgrades. As the sun rose in Florida, recovery ship Megan left Port Canaveral with the Dragon training capsule on board. Back at Boca Chica, two new liquid oxygen propellant pumps were delivered and unloaded at the launch site. Over at the Sanchez site, a new cryo tank was delivered and unloaded as well. Late that afternoon, Doug towed Just Read the Instructions out to sea from Port Canaveral ahead of Crew 5 launch. With Starship 24's Starlink dispenser door now welded shut, the temporary scaffolding was removed from the ship, closing out a very busy Monday. In the early morning hours, Booster 9's thrust section was rolled into Mega Bay, with the hydraulic power units deleted from the vehicle. This booster will be the first to use the upcoming electrically driven thrust vector control arms. As the ground track forecast for the hurricane became more certain, NASA officials ultimately made the decision to roll Artemis 1 back to the vehicle assembly building overnight, where it would be sheltered against the upcoming storm. The VAB built for the Apollo program was designed to withstand a direct hit from the Category 3 hurricane. Over at the Port Canaveral docks, Falcon 9 booster B-1067 was laid onto the horizontal transporter and returned to Roberts Road. Over at LC-39A, Buckner's LR-11-350 was lowered ahead of the hurricane's arrival. Upright crawler cranes are typically rated for winds up to 60 miles per hour. Back in Boca Chica, a ship nose cone was moved down Highway 4 before returning to the build site through the ring yard gate. As part of SpaceX's ongoing engineering development efforts, the can crusher cap could be seen being lifted onto the shift aft section test article. On Wednesday morning, Starship 26's 5 rings tall payload bay section was moved into the high bay. Later, after the sun rose, the ship's payload bay section was attached to the high bay crane and placed onto the turntable. Over at the launch site, scaffolding began to be placed around the legs of the orbital launch mount. Propellant loading infrastructure work also continued as the new methane pump motor was lifted and put into place. The studded but otherwise tileless and flapless nose cone, tentatively identified for Starship 26, was moved into the high bay. The relatively bare nose cone was rolled out of the high bay about an hour later. Shortly after, a sheet metal assembly, possibly shielding for the booster's center engines, was moved into the mega bay. On Thursday, the hurricane was felt across the state, including in Port Canaveral, with choppy seas and heavy rain battering ships, plant life, buildings, and infrastructure across the coastline throughout the day. Workers at Boca Chica attempted to lift a new methane pump before lowering it back down. A second attempt was more successful, and the new pump was put into place at the methane side of the orbital launch tank farm. With the pump installed, the motor was pulled off spot 4 and placed on the top of the new pump. Later, the pump in the fourth spot was removed and placed onto a nearby pallet to be prepared for transport away from the farm. And finally for this week, thanks to a timely heads up from our friends at RGV Aerial Photography, the E-Dome test tank that was relocated to Massey's former gun range appears to have been tested to failure. Whether or not this was intentional is still unclear. And there you have it, another SpaceX and Starbase weekly update brought to you by LabPadre. Make sure you subscribe and hit the alert bell for new video and live stream notifications. We'll see you next week, and thanks for watching. LabPadre out.